The future of healthcare is often portrayed with a robot or artificial intelligence. While some of that is happening on the fringes, the real future of healthcare is emerging right now. And it's happening because of the pandemic.
Coronavirus is not a 2 to 3 month problem. We are going to be struggling with this directly for months and months and indirectly for years. So healthcare needs to change.
A new normal for healthcare is being established, and your doctor's visit may never be the same again.
There is no reason that healthcare needs to operate the way that it does.
This is Dr. Carolyn Jasek, Chief Medical Officer for the digital health company, Omada.
At our company, we work with folks with obesity and diabetes and hypertension, you know, the top three identified conditions that make you most at risk for complications for COVID. We have to figure out how to serve these patients in their homes, and that's really new for healthcare.
$41 billion of venture capital funds have been spent on digital health companies. Most have failed, partially because few employees ever use their telemedicine programs, even though 90% of large companies offered them. HIPAA regulations and other rules have also curbed the industry's development.
It is easier and more convenient to order a cheeseburger from McDonald's on an app than it is to access healthcare in America.
Previous to the pandemic, insurance would only pay for services at the point of care, meaning a patient receiving treatment at the doctor's office or hospital. But this has all changed in the last couple of months, driven by the largest insurer in the United States, Medicaid and Medicare.
Barriers that were seemingly insurmountable, things like reimbursement and cross-state licensure, are now being solved in order to get these solutions out to people. And that's exciting to see these things getting into people's hands for the first time.
On April 30th, the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services allowed for digital health reimbursements and relaxed rules around video visits. It has spawned over 80 new services so far, and that number is only going to increase. For doctors and clinicians, they've had to quickly hack together solutions so they can continue to serve patients. If their practice doesn't already have an app, they're using Zoom or FaceTime, services that were forbidden to use previously. Now, healthcare companies are seeing astronomical increases in video visits. Other things, like prescription filling, have become that much easier. And for clinicians, who only used to be licensed to treat patients in their same state, they're now allowed to treat patients across the country.
For the first time, through a smartphone, people can get efficient, high-quality care at an affordable price with good outcomes at a time when people really need that.
But the question is this here to stay? As we ride the waves of coronavirus, and everyone has to use all of these digital tools, will we get used to them? Will we have a better healthcare system, with people doing most of their visits from home and only going into the clinic when absolutely necessary? Are we living through a fundamental shift in the healthcare model? Investors seem to think so, as funding for new digital health companies exploded in the first quarter of 2020.
I don't believe that healthcare will ever be the same again.
You look back a century ago at medicine, and the tools and procedures that people were using seemed crazy. Cocaine as medicine, no gloves for surgery, ambulance by horse. But that was cutting edge for its time. What will our descendants look at now that they'll view as archaic? Will the idea that we regularly went in to see our doctor be laughable? That we waited until something hurt to find out that we had a health problem? That we paid astronomical amounts for the simplest of visits?
I'm so proud of the health tech community that we've been able to step up during this time and that we've been ready for it.
The losses from COVID-19 are devastating, but hopefully this change in how we deliver healthcare may in the end save millions of lives. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please give us a like and subscribe to Freethink for more great stories of people changing the world.